Hello and welcome to Chartbusters. Well, this is a show where we normally highlight all the buzzing stocks of the day. We'll also get you a quick trade on the Nifty as well. I'm Nigel D'Souza, and with me as always, Mangalam Malu. Hey Mangalam, well, last day of the year, it's been a good eventful year. The Nifty is holding with some gains, with a gain of around 30 points odd. Come off a tad bit from the top, but I don't know who all are trading today. I mean, so many people would be off.
Well, there are two ways to look at it. You can either say it's the last day of the year, or you can say it's the first day of the week. So let's see how it goes. Tomorrow, we're going to be here. We're going to say this is the first Chartbusters of 2019, just as we would say this is the last Chartbusters of 2018.
I think it makes more sense to say the first day of the week, because today we're saying last, and tomorrow suddenly we'll all be back here. You know, irrespective of what time the party gets over, we'll be here.
Or irrespective of whether there is a party or not.
Yeah, that.
Well, all right. So on that note, what we do is we take a look at all the top stories that we're tracking on the last morning, if you must, of 2018. But before that, our director says we have Ashwini with us too. Ashwini, 10,914, which is the 100-day moving average, coincides with the high point of the day as well. Do you think that can be taken out in the remainder of this day, or consolidation as it's the last day of the week, last day of the year, if you must?
See, what will happen today is that the bears are probably getting the message that this market is not really willing to go down. So the moment we kind of get cues towards the upside, I think 11,000 should get taken out. Whether it happens today seems unlikely, but I think mid caps are slowly picking up steam, and I think this sort of broad market breadth should finally lead the market to head on the upside. So my sense is to keep buying these dips, and finally we should get past 11,000. For the moment, construction stocks are having a good time. So Aluwalia contracts, and now it's time to look at such stocks. That's a buy with a stop of 324, target of 342. UPL is a buy with a stop of 760, target of 785. And NBCC is a buy with a stop of 57, target of 62.
Right. Ashwini, just looking at a couple of these F&O gainers, we have Chennai Petro, which has suddenly moved higher, about half of its gain coming by in just the last 15 odd minutes. Along with that, we have MCX2, which is moving higher. Any technical calls out there? Chennai Petro and MCX?
Well, Chennai Petro has just crossed its 200-day moving average at 295. So, broadly mid-caps are recovering, they are healing. So, possibly 340, 345 on Chennai Petro. Similar, things on MCX. Again, the stock never really is able to break ground, but 770 is the 200-day moving average. It's been flat for the better part of this year since February. So basically, the big moves happen only beyond 850, 860. Both seem to be a bit of dogs. I think in terms of mid caps, look at construction, infrastructure, cap goods, the capex type stocks, and they should do very well.
All right. What about a couple of these pharma names? I'm looking at a couple of stocks. Ajanta Pharma has moved up in the last few minutes. That's picking up on higher volumes. But that's been a relative underperform, I think, in this year. The stock that's done well this year is Divi's Laboratory. Now, that's given you returns of more than 30% this year. And as we speak, the stock moves to the high point of the day. Any trade on any of these pharma counters, Ashwini?
See, because the sector overall hasn't really participated. So if you want to participate here, then stay with the outperformers, and in that sense, DV's Lab is one of them. So my sense would be that with a stop, say, around 1430 odd, DV's Lab could get up to 1700.
Disclosures, Ashwini?
We have long positions on Bank Nifty.
All right. Thanks a lot for stopping by and giving us all your cues, Ashwini. We will keep coming back to you all through the course of the day. Just as we take a short break, keep an eye out on Reliance. That stock has taken a bit of a knock, currently trading at the low point of the day, but the index still supported under the 10,900 mark.